FDR once said, "We have always held to the hope, the belief, the conviction that there is a better life, a better world beyond the horizon." Franklin D. Roosevelt was a great man. He was born in New York in the late 1880s and grew up in a high-class family, yet he maintained a status as a man of the people. Franklin was a very smart young man and grew up doing well in school. He did so well, in fact, that he was admitted and graduated from Harvard. He would then go on to marry his fifth cousin, Eleanor Roosevelt, with whom he would have five children. FDR's political career began when he started and ran for New York Senator. He won and became a United States Senator for the state of New York. Later, he was appointed Assistant Secretary of the Navy. He was viewed as a great politician with amazing leadership skills. In 1920, Roosevelt ran for vice president but lost by a landslide. Soon after, FDR would contract polio at age 39, a disease that will forever change his life and ultimately lead to his death. Roosevelt hid this disease and made sure the American people did not know how crippled he was from polio. In 1932, FDR was elected president of the United States. He was elected during the peak of the Great Depression, one of, if not the most difficult time in American history. Roosevelt released the New Deal. This was a group of economic policies that were targeted to fix the economic spiral that was caused by the Great Depression. FDR was a symbol of hope and a voice the American people could believe in during these disastrous times. Just as the American economy was finally recovering, Nazi Germany began World War II. FDR saw this and made a plan not to join the war initially, but remain on the sidelines to protect the American people. Eventually, Japan bombed Pearl Harbor, and FDR chose to join the war and fight against Japan, Germany, and Italy. Roosevelt continued to run for office and won his fourth term, as he understood the American people needed a continuity of leadership during this great war. He led America to near victory, and if it wasn't for his untimely death, he would have finished the war. Unfortunately, he died from polio early in his fourth term in office. He was an incredible man that helped establish the mindset and the foundation of America as we see it today. He reminded us, the only thing we have to fear is fear itself.